So this is where those beasts get their magical blood from. Once that ancient fella in Baxter was sucked dry, she found you, huh? Christ, I'm starting to hate mythology.
Money.
Is it true what I heard? That you broke that glamour and ripped that place and...
Locked. Hope my father's okay.
Oh, there you are, Mr. Rinty. Doctor.
I'm taking it.
With that technology, we could have freed the Great Plains of Tick Trouble in no time. That gauntlet of his? That's what I call research and development. I tell you, there was big money in the manor. Not like this backwater. You think young Rentier would invest in Calico?
He can't invest in nothing. He's flat busted. The gold comes from DC. Harrow's the one who calls the shots here.
Rentier's back, but he gave that Felicity a scare.
This is just one battle and an ongoing war with an immortal enemy.
That immortal enemy lost their sanctuary.
I know it's working, Verge, but we could sure use another one.
The technology behind those coils is so sophisticated, I'm amazed I was able to get it working. Just wait your turn.
And I thought we were friends. Why do you think I spent so much time singing your praises to Mr. Rentier?
Jesus, Martin. Give me some slack, for goodness sake. I'm under enough pressure as it is.
Relax. I'm pretty sure he thinks I'm blowing smoke up his ass.
Anybody ever heard of a colossal monster with a forest growing on its back? Because I got some samples.
Mine.
That's a Mikinak. In Huron Indian folklore, it's some kind of minor deity.
It was covered head to toe in those damn leeches.
That means we found yet another blood factory set up by Debano and Felicity.
That would explain why they attacked Baxter. They were protecting their source. The ancient blood they used to transform their familiars.
Bad news is this Mykonak thing was supplying their war for quite some time now, allowing those foul bloods to spread all over the country. The good news is, they won't do it anymore.
Help! Dr. Blackwell, somebody!
Aside. Even if he doesn't kill us in our sleep, that link in his head will lead the Ticks right to us.
Then let them come. Killing Ticks is what the Rentier Institute does.
You listen to yourself? This isn't about your birthright. This is what happens when we run a government agency like a goddamn monarchy. All our protocols go out the window as soon as Daddy Dearest...
Keep talking to me about the rules, you bureaucratic shrew.
Please, we're all on the same team, remember?
Only when it suits him. How about finally telling me where Edgar went?
He's in Moripaw, searching for the plant to make the regen compound.
The regen compound? Now you're wasting what little resources we have left chasing a fairy tale?
Listen, Mr. Gravener's an experienced agent. If he didn't have faith in his mission, he wouldn't bother. We are at war, Doctor. Who else is worth saving if not the leader of the Institute? And in the long run, it could help everybody if the thing by some miracle actually works.
You have until tomorrow morning. In the meantime, your father will be restrained and placed under round-the-clock supervision.
Fine. I'm gonna get Edgar's ass out of those swamps. And if I get back with that plant and I still see that shotgun in your hand, you better damn well prove you know how to use it.
You picked a strange time to assert yourself, Virgil. Why'd you back Jesse's quest for this ridiculous compound?
Just because the scientists at the manor didn't find anything? Doesn't mean there isn't something there. I mean, did they ever let you take a look?
No.
We have a habit at Calico of making the impossible happen, Doctor. I fixed Mr. Jesse's gauntlet, made it better even. Scott found the best lead we have with those leeches. If anyone can make that compound work, it's you.
Those are Edgar's. Must have found that plant here. I'll take that. The trail leads this way. Christ. Wish I had a map of this place. That sounds like trouble.
Oh!
something broke the boat, but it looks like you managed to escape. Must have been in a hurry if he dropped his damn crossbow. I'm sure Edgar wouldn't mind if I took advantage of this little beauty. Nothing alive here except those freaks. Okay. whole place smells like death. Jesus. Who the hell would want to set up camp here? Blood everywhere in one big-ass spider web. I hate spiders. Ash and blood. Finders keepers. Twisted and covered with thorns. It grows only in the marshlands. They're teeth marks. Oh, it's sucked dry. Why? Some desperate soul looking for a cure? It's of no use to me now. That eight-legged freak was hunting him down. Guess this is that giant arachnid's lair. He's not wrapped up like a mummy in a web. Guess he got away. Thank you.
All right, let's stick to the facts. Bloom Research vampiric legends. A lot of myths and hoo-ha about some sort of plant. One that could allegedly reverse the process of the change. It's considered an affront to the purity of the royal blood.
Ominous. But can it work? From a biological point of view?
Now and then, some of those legends contain a grain of truth. An endemic species like this may have peculiar properties. If researched properly, some cell mutations, I don't know.
Imagine how many people we could save if you made it work.
Look, I'm not a miracle worker, Virgil, but I'll give it my best shot.
Got killed to keep that plant safe, but kept on going. That's true grit. Both used to be thick as thieves. Got it. Thank you. almost there.
Whoa, didn't expect that in this damn jungle.
Did you break this damn bridge, Edgar?
Ah, now I need to find another way.
Better run quick before it sinks. Smash!
More money.
Gotta be careful. Out of my way. Thank you. quite a find. There. This could come in handy. This thing down on top of me. Money. Church over there.
Come on. have just improved your looks.
Make it. More money. I'm almost there. Suddenly get some religion? I'm taking it. Okay. Doesn't look inviting, but let's say I trust you, Edgar. Edgar, I'm starting to doubt your navigational abilities.
here. Find a way. Move those damn blocks. Whatever you gotta do.
just move. this way. Should work now.
Over here!
Just a little more.
Edgar? Just behind you!
Thank you. Thanks for the hand. But I had it under control.
Can tell.
I found the plan. The locals call it La Orquídea de la Vida, or something foreign like that. We get this back to Calico, squeeze it out, and maybe we have ourselves a way to turn this around.
I'm sorry I got you into this.
Getting your ass out of the fire has kind of become a habit.
Edgar, you can't keep doing this forever.
When those ticks attacked the manor, what did your father do? Run? Nah. He kept on squeezing the trigger. That's what he did. People like us don't retire, Jesse. Even if you're lucky enough to live long enough, you'll soon realize there's nothing waiting for you. There is no normal for people like me or your father. And I was naive to think there might be some normal for you. Anyway, now that just about everyone else in the Institute is dead, I figure you and your daddy are gonna need all the help you can get to build things back up again.
Well, first you give me those pretty flowers, then you get all emotional on me. Edgar, you ain't gonna try to kiss me now, are you?
You little shit. Damn it. Harrow's here.
You backstabbing witch! You ratted us out!
Dr. Blackwell, I know we've had our differences, but this...
For your information, I had nothing to do with Mr. Harrow's sudden appearance on our doorstep. But thank you for confirming how little faith you have in me. Now, I don't presume to know how things work for you, gentlemen. But I can assure you that Calico wasn't built on broken words and betrayed confidences. Women in my position don't have that privilege. Now, I assume you have the plant?
We do.
Good. And there are clean syringes and alcohol swabs in the lab.
5 minutes is all we need.
Kicking ass.
I tell you one thing. Grabiner's the real deal. Tough as nails, no bullshit. Not right, foul. Shit. It might turn the tide of this war. Happy to-